Good evening, sisters and brothers. Right, we are going to start the children now here. We are waiting for the children. And just to remind you, as I mentioned before, those who are sitting here on this side, we will be bringing you communion. All the others will come forward for communion using the center aisle and also the aisle by the Christmas tree. Please make sure you have a newsletter with you. If not one, two, you can take and give it to somebody, because there are people who don't know still what is happening in the parish. So if you could take a few newsletters with you, I'd really appreciate. And also we have left some offertory envelopes on your pews, and there will be an offertory. You can put your offertory into that envelope. Because of the COVID situation, we are not able to go around and do the collection. And the collection baskets are at the back of the church. So whatever is offering, you can put that to the collection basket at the back of the church. Yeah. And please, when you leave the church, be very careful. Please keep a gap between each other, and also don't remove your mask, please, until you are outside of the church. Thank you. Now we will bless the nativity scene. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the God of every nation and people. From the very beginning of creation, you have made manifest your love. When our need for our Savior was great, you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary. To our lives, he brings joy and peace, justice, mercy, and love. Lord, bless all who look upon this manger. May it remind us of the humble birth of Jesus and raise our thoughts to him who is God with us and Savior of all, and who lives and reigns forever and ever. evening, sisters and brothers, and welcome to this Vigil Mass. This Mass is specially for the children, and it's good to have the children with us this evening. I'm going to ask Zach to come forward and light the last candle on the Advent wreath, please. During this Mass, we pray everybody gathered here and also for your family members and friends, and especially all those who have asked us to remember them during this Mass. So now, to prepare ourselves for this celebration, let us pause for a moment and think of the mercy and goodness of God. Lord Jesus, Son of God, you were born of the Virgin to become one like us. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, Son of Man, you heal our weakness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, firstborn of the Father, you gather us as one family. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory in the highest. Glory to God. Glory in the highest.
Lord God in heaven, you are the mighty and wonderful. We worship you. We give you thanks. We
us pray. Good and gracious God, on this holy night you gave us your Son, the Lord of the universe, wrapped in swaddling clothes, the Savior of all, lying in a manger. On this holy night, draw us into the mystery of your love. Join our voices with the heavenly host, that we may sing your glory on high. Give us a place among the shepherds, that we may find the one for whom we have waited, Jesus Christ, your Word made flesh, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, in the splendor of eternal life, God forever and ever. Please be seated for the speech.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. About Zion, I will not be silent. About Jerusalem, I will not grow weary. Until her integrity shines out like the dawn, and her salvation flames like a torch. The nations then will see your integrity, all the kings your glory, and you will be called by a new name, one which the mouth of the Lord will confer. You are to be a crown of splendor in the hand of the Lord, a princely diadem in the hand of your God. No longer are you to be named forsaken, nor your land abandoned, but you shall be called my delight, and your land the wedded. For the Lord takes delight in you, and your land will have its wedding. Like a young man marrying a virgin, so will the one who built you wed you. And as the bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so will your God rejoice in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Paul reached Antioch in Pisidia, he stood up in the synagogue, held up a hand for silence, and began to speak. Men of Israel and fearers of God, listen. The God of our nation Israel chose our ancestors and made our people great when they were living as foreigners in Egypt. Then, by divine power, he led them out. Then he made David their king, of whom he approved in these words, I have selected David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, who will carry out my whole purpose. To keep his promise, God has raised up for Israel one of David's descendants, Jesus, a savior, whose coming was heralded by John when he proclaimed a baptism of repentance for the whole people of Israel. Before John ended his career, he said, I am not the one you imagine me to be. That one is coming after me, and I am not fit to undo his sandal. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand for the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Tomorrow there will be an end to the sin of the world, and the Saviour of the world will be our King.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. This is how Jesus Christ came to be born. His mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they came to live together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Her husband, Joseph, being a man of honour and wanting to spare her publicity, decided to divorce her informally. He'd made up his mind to do this when the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because she has conceived what is in her by the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you must name him Jesus, because he is the one who is to save his people from their sins." Now all this took place to fulfill the words spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," a name which means God is with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord told him to do. He took his wife to his home. And though he had not had intercourse with her, she gave birth to a son, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Please be seated and now listen to the reading.
It's a real privilege to be able to have the children to celebrate the Nativity this Christmas, given that we weren't able to last year. And it's been a really impromptu gathering of children, and thanks very much for being so willing. So if I can ask any of the children who are involved today, if you can just come and sit on the floor here in front of this bench, that'd be brilliant. And then when I call you up, you'll have an easier travel. Just on the floor there, that's the end. There's going to be a little bit of audience participation from all of you tonight, so we'll have a little practice now, if that's okay. I'm going to ask you a question, what's it all about? And your response is going to be love, and it would be great if we could hear you really loudly and clearly. So let's have a practice now. What's it all about?
Love.
Let's try again. What's it all about?
Love.
Thank you. Right. Are we good, kids? Our little play is going to need some audience participation. We're going to need you to join in with excitement and anticipation. What is to come might look a little here and there, but we all know the story that we're about to share. and what's it all about, what was said from above. The story of Christmas, well, it's all about love. So I'll ask you a question, what's it all about? When I ask it, the answer, love, you will shout. What's it all about?
Love.
What's it all about?
Love.
We're going to need a Mary for our story to start. And an angel to visit Mary's loving, brave heart. Mary's yes to the angel long ago on that day meant when I ask the next question, you'll know what to say. What's it all about?
Love.
A donkey and Joseph are who we'll need next. The journey to Bethlehem was probably stressed, but Donkey and Joseph will have carried their load, neither grumbling nor moaning on that dusty road. Because what's it all about?
Love.
When the baby was born, angels in song filled the sky, and shepherds, where are shepherds? Rushed to the stable. They didn't stop to ask why. And a star up above with a light for all to see led the kings and a camel. If you guys go that way. With gifts for the baby. Because what's it all about?
Love.
And Jesus, born and laid in a manger of hay, brought a peace and a promise to us all that day, that no matter what happens, whatever we go through, we are loved. We are loved with a love strong and true. Because what's it all about?
Love.
Can we give them a round of applause?
Thank you.
Thank you, Christine and the children. It was great to see them here. We were looking for children just before Mass. We thought we would not have any, but they appeared little by little, you know. It's great to have them. And also it's great to see you all this evening, this joy to celebrate with you Christmas. And as you know, we have come together as one community now. We have closed down St. Aidan, so this has become the Church of St. Agnes and St. Aidan. So this is the very first Christmas we celebrate as one community. And also it's important that we give thanks to God that we are able to come together. Unlike for people in many other parts of the world, people still who are waiting for the first vaccine. So we are really privileged people. And I thought of tonight to speak about and reflect on the innkeeper. I don't know if you noticed an innkeeper among the children. And each of us is an innkeeper who decides if there is room for Jesus. Mary and Joseph went looking for a place of safety, a place of little comfort, but no one bothered to give them a room for a woman heavily pregnant. But it was their first time at that inn, and they did not know what they had to that they had to show up early. They didn't know a lot of things. How could they? That is what being a stranger means. Not being known is part of it, but not knowing is the rest. I wonder whether those door slamming innkeepers ever regretted their decision not to give the couple a room, even a couch, or even a little mattress on the floor. Maybe some of them pretended to be too busy and completely ignored the couple. They missed that opportunity to have that plaque. I'm sure you have seen in famous places they have this plaque to see what happened. To say, Holy Family stayed here, or Jesus was born here. It is important to remember my decisions and your decisions could make a difference and have a ripple effect in the life of someone out there. Someone who is also looking for a place of safety, a place of a little comfort, a place of opportunities, a place to rest, a place to laugh and play again, a place to live again in freedom, a place to live a normal life. I'm sure all of us remember the images we saw from Afghanistan or what happened in the English Channel recently. We cannot forget all those in poor countries who were sent vaccines a week before the expiry date. Those who are yet to receive the first vaccine, while the rich nations are thinking of the second booster, or some of them are thinking of the fourth vaccine. No surprise, there are many people on the move today. So we remind ourselves that each one of us is an innkeeper who decides if there is room for Jesus. Sometimes we look back in life and regret the opportunities we lost to be that kind and welcoming innkeeper, to make a difference in those people who came into our lives, total strangers who were lost. We can spend hours at meetings and talk about the hospitality towards the stranger, or the famous word today, another inquiry. And we can ignore the stranger we see in the village, at the checkouts, at the fish and chip shop, on public transport, or on the way to school with our kids, and even in the church. Rather than becoming irritated at the foreigner who cannot explain himself or herself at the checkout, or on the bus or the train, I think Jesus is asking us to be creative and to be compassionate. Jesus is asking us to use our gifts, our technology, whether it is Google Translator, Facebook, or website, all those tools we take for granted, so that we can help that man, that woman, or that child, so that we can make them feel welcome, because they also bear the image of God. So again, we remind ourselves that each of us is an innkeeper who decides if there is room for Jesus. I'm always amazed by the generosity of some people during Christmas. People who reach out to those most in need. And I received a lot of hampers recently, and I went around distributing them to a number of families. And it was very touching when I went to one of the families. They told me they don't need that hamper because they received one an hour before. They could have easily accepted because I wasn't there to see what happened. But they asked me to give it to somebody who may be in need. I'm also touched by some of our parishioners who have decided to welcome people who otherwise will spend Christmas alone. So I want to thank them for reminding people that we can be good innkeepers. It is also a reminder that we are good, we are all good, and that we care. It may be good to remind the goodness in us here today, but it's important that we keep that spirit of openness and generosity throughout the year, not just during Christmas. But we still meet some people, some leaders, who find every rule, every law, every document on earth to make it more or less impossible or dangerous to be a good and welcoming innkeeper. One of the parishioners once told me, "Father, health and safety has become the best excuse for some people who are looking for a getaway clause not to reach out to those in need." We need to be risk takers who ask the right questions and who are willing to challenge those in power to find a way to welcome the stranger, because that stranger is also a child of God. I'm sure many people are doing that already. I know some people who have asked the people from time to time to come for a couple, as you say here. It doesn't have to be a three-course meal. It's still, they will feel welcome. Because at the end of our journey, let us not be in that group of innkeepers who may have regretted slamming the door to the Holy Family. And let us be proactive and creative and also risk takers. And as we know, Jesus took risks. He cured people on the Sabbath day, and Jesus spoke to the Samaritan woman at the well, and he went and had a meal with Matthew, the tax collector. We can celebrate from time to time because there are still many good innkeepers who have a lot of room in their heart for the welfare of others. And I'm sure many of you watch television or listen to the news. Recently, they awarded the Nobel Peace Prize to two journalists, Dmitry Mortov and Maria Ryssa. And Dmitry is Russian and Maria is a Filipino. They continue to take enormous risk in exposing corrupt leaders, corrupt governments, and they have become the voice to the many voiceless and a voice to the strangers. And these are two people who have let the struggling, the mistreated Holy Families of today into the rooms of their heart. So we need to ask ourselves, what can I do? I know it's a children's mass. I might be talking too long too. And just children, I'm sure. Children, you can always challenge your parents to ask them to invite a total stranger to the Christmas dinner. I don't know whether I will get in trouble at the end of mass. And ask yourself whether you visited the strangers who recently moved to your street. Be friendly with someone who has a different color, different accent, or different status. When you do that, you open the door to your in and door to your heart. So let not social media frighten us with false information. Let us continue to remind ourselves that we are all children of God. So today, as we celebrate Christmas, we also celebrate all that good you have done and the good people have done to you. So let us think with grateful hearts all those who have been good innkeepers. And let us thank God for Pope Francis, who continues to be a good role model to all Christians, who is often thinking outside of the box. Let us also remember people like Archbishop Oscar Romero, I'm sure you have seen the picture out there on the wall, Mother Teresa, Archbishop Helder Camara, and Father James Martin, who reminds us what it is to be a good innkeeper and welcome everyone regardless of people's color, race, gender, or sexual orientation. So let me end this with the words of Archbishop Oscar Romero, who said, "We must not seek the child Jesus in the pretty figures of our Christmas scripts. We must seek him among the undernourished children who have gone to bed at night with nothing to eat." May I also add that we must seek child Jesus in the stranger who is also looking for a place of safety, a place of opportunities, a place to rest, a place to laugh and to play again, a place to live again with freedom, a place to live a normal life. So let us not forget that each of us is an innkeeper who decides if there is room for Jesus. Please stand and let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the union of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My sisters and brothers, in this first Eucharist of Christmas and the end of a most difficult year, we pray for the people of our church and of our world as we look into the face of the newborn Jesus.
That Jesus, the Son of Mary, and protected by Joseph, will bless all of our families with peace and care for those who struggle with sadness, unemployment, and sickness, and all those who have have to leave their homeland because of conflict, famine, or for lack of opportunities. We pray for those that are lonely and isolated from society. May they be renewed and comforted with strength from the Holy Spirit to overcome their feelings of seclusion. That Jesus, our Prince of Peace, will restore peace to the nations of the world, religious freedom to those persecuted for their faith, and respect among all people. Teach us to see clearly that we, your children, are far more alike than we are different. Help us to put aside the racial prejudices embedded within us and to see within every person the child of God you created, our sister or brother, destined for glory. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That Jesus, our Saviour, will take into the embrace of his mercy our departed family members, along with all of our parishioners who have died since last Christmas. We especially remember today Anne Nora Edwards, Peter Henshaw, and Eileen Ash, who recently passed away. We also pray for those whose anniversaries occur around this time, especially those mentioned in our newsletter. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And may the perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen.
Let us pray for a few moments in the silence of our hearts. Let us ask Mary, the mother of our Saviour, to pray with us as we say together,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen. Lord our God, we worship your Son, Jesus, born this night, and ask that you give us that wonder and joy which Mary and Joseph experienced in the stable of Bethlehem so long ago. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the opportunity. Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, Lord God, on this festive night, that through this holy exchange we may become like Christ, in whom our nature is united to your Godhead. Grant this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In the great mystery of his birth, the God we cannot see have now appeared in human form. The one begotten before all ages begins to live in time. He has come to raise the fallen world, to make creation whole again, and to lead humanity from exile back to your heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels and saints, we sing the joyful hymn of your praise. Fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread, therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Malcolm, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, but with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As we say the Lord's Prayer, we thank God that we had the opportunity to come together, and we also ask the Lord to guide us as we look forward to a new church and a community center here in a few years' time. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. As we cannot hug and kiss and shake hands, but please give a wave to each other during the sign of peace. So let us offer each other the sign of peace. My sisters and brothers, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. and say the spiritual communion prayer for those who are joining us via the YouTube live stream. Jesus, my Lord and brother, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I decide to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come now spiritually into my heart. I welcome you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Just to remind you, the communion will be distributed. There will be two Eucharistic ministers here, and one of us will stand there next to the Christmas tree, and those on that side can use that aisle to come forward, please. And those on this side, we will be bringing communion to where you are. And also, I want to encourage you to come and receive communion. Maybe you have not been able to come to church for some time for various reasons. But just to remind you, you don't have to be perfect to receive communion. Whether you're on that side of the altar or this side of the altar, none of us are perfect. And also important for us to remember the words of Pope Francis, who said, the Eucharist is not a prize for the perfect, but a powerful medicine and nourishment for the weak. So you are more than welcome to come and receive communion. If you still decide not to receive communion, you can come forward for a blessing. And if you are coming forward for a blessing, please have your arms across your chest so that you know we know that you are coming forward for a blessing.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error fighting, till He appeared and
praise His holy name.
sing our Silent Night and turn off the lights. If you could light all the candles that you have in your hands, please. Please stand with the candles. Let us pray. Lord our God, we celebrate with joy the birth of our Redeemer. Grant that through worthy and holy lives, we may be welcomed into his glorious company forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. First, on behalf of the sisters, Sister Elizabeth, Sister Mary Rose, and also sisters of the daughters of St. Paul, And Father Richard, myself, and the deacons, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. And I also want to remind you, I'm sure everybody has got one of those candles. As you leave the church, please don't leave the candle behind. I would really appreciate if you could take that candle home and light that when you gather together for your three-course meal, you know, for your Christmas dinner. And to just to remind them, you know, and to what we have done today, and also to give them our best wishes for Christmas and also for the new year, that hopefully the new year that we will begin soon will be a good one, a healthier one than the last year, and that we will have less lockdown, so we won't have any lockdown. So we pray that it will be a good one. And I will really appreciate if you could take at least two of these newsletters and put one through your neighbor's letterbox. And there are a few things that we do in the parish we like to people to be aware of. And one of the things is that there is a meeting coming up on the 13th of January at 7 o'clock at St. Andrew's Parish Club. And I would really appreciate if you could try your best to come to this meeting. This is due with our new church and the community center that we hope to build here in a 2.5 years time, hopefully, as long as we are able to raise 2.5 million. So you need to pray hard and help us, I'm sure you will. But we'll give you more details, but I would really appreciate as the first step if you could come to this meeting on the 13th of January. And also, please continue to support our parish club, St. Aidan's Club. There are rumors that we are going to close it. We are not closing the club. We only close St. Aidan's Church. And also, to remind you, there is a LGBT plus support group in the parish that meets every third Sunday at 6 o'clock. Please pass the word around. And also, ask the friends and family members, you know, to support the Mary's Meals project that we do through the parish. Now all the information is here, so I hope and pray that you will take the newsletters home. Anybody celebrating birthday today or in the coming week? Right, I can't see that. Oh, Chris, is that Chris? Yeah, that's like Chris, sorry. I saw you, Ruth, yeah. Alex? Kevin, yeah, that's right. Alex? That's right, yeah. Anybody else? Right, very good, Alex. Yes, that's great. So we can't unfortunately sing happy birthday, so we are going to clap happy birthday and wish them good health and many more birthdays. I just want to thank everybody for your support. All those who have worked very hard, the ladies who have done the decorations, and the stewards who work hard to get the manger scene ready in time. And also the altar servers for helping us, and to Father Richard, sisters, and everybody who has supported us and as we prepared for Christmas. So thank you very much, and also continue to remember us in your prayers. As I mentioned before, we have become one community now, and we hope to journey together and do wonderful things, not just for the church, but also for the communities. Once again, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a good and healthy New Year, with no lockdowns.
Just to say a word of thanks too, because I don't know if you noticed, this building, this church, it was modeled on a Bedouin tent, and you can see it in the light like this. You know, you can see the tent and all the flap sides open. That was the model for this. And the Bedouins used to have their tent sides open to welcome everybody in. And Anton there talking about the innkeeper. Well, there's no doubt about it, he's the innkeeper in chief, because the way and the welcome and he gives to everybody is quite remarkable. So I just want to thank him on all our behalf for all that amazingly hard work and wonderful welcoming that he offers to everybody.
Thank you. And just to remind the children, there are some sweets I have brought for all the children, so I hope I'll see you at the back of the church by the manger. Please stand. So when I bring my hands together, please respond by saying Amen at the end of each invocation. Through the incarnation of His Son, God has scattered the darkness of the world, and by Christ's glorious birth, which angels announced to the shepherds, has brightened this most holy night. May the God of infinite goodness banish the darkness of sin from our hearts and make them radiant with the light of goodness.
Amen.
May God fill you with the joy of the shepherds and make you heralds of the gospel.
Amen.
May the God who joins heaven and earth fill you with peace and goodwill and unite you in fellowship with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And before the final blessing, I just want to thank the children for the wonderful thank you, Christine, and all the catechists. Thank you very much. So may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thank you
very much, and have a good day, and wish you all a Merry Christmas. Yeah, put it in the camera. Okay, all right.